Hey, good morning. Sound my check. Just hey, good morning. Sound testing. Sound check. Checking. Testing my check 1 2. Just hey. Sound check. Testing.
Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. With joyful hearts, we gather here today to share and witness the sacrament of matrimony of Migoy and Francis as they celebrate the love and become one in heart, body, and soul, that God may bless their new life as husband and wife. Please remain seated as we welcome the entourage. Please all stand to welcome the bride, Francis.
Night after night, we stay together. sharing lovely moments that spell forever. Day after day, our love gets stronger, growing every minute that we get closer. If we ever have to say
Presider, Reverend Father Rani Heraldino.
Let us begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and love of God the Father, and our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Jesus said, "Where two or three gather in my name, there am I in their midst. How much more so when two people so in love gather in His name." This is an important and beautiful day for all of us gathered here in this Eucharist. Let us ask the Lord to bless Migoy and Frances, to give them strength and to help them persevere through all the trials that married life brings. Let us now praise God for the sacrament of matrimony with which He will bless Migoy and Frances. Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, we pray for this your servants, Migoy and Frances, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all wild animals. But none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, "The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord." Please repeat.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
They are happy whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own. The Lord looks on those who revere him, on those who hope his love.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
Our soul is waiting for the Lord. The Lord is our help and our shield. In him do our hearts find joy. We trust in his holy name.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord.
May your love be upon us, O Lord, as we place all our hopes in you.
The earth is full of the goodness of the Lord. Please all rise to honor the Holy Gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that he lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. Then the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
Magandang umaga po, Father.
Good morning, Migoy and Francis. This is the day that the Lord has made for you, and we are just on the sixth day of the new year, and this is a very providential time to begin a new chapter of your life. This 2022 will mark the beginning of your journey as a couple, as a married couple. And in Europe, this day, the 6th of January, is a special day for them. In fact, it's a second Christmas. Every 6th of January in the other part of the world is the Feast of the Kings, the Three Kings, and they give gifts to each other. It's like a second Christmas. In fact, they call it the Christmas for the rich, no? Because only the rich, no, have that capacity to give gifts the second time around. And I believe this is also your Feast of the Kings, because you are giving yourself as a gift to the other. And that is the best gift that you could offer. Not material things, not material riches or wealth, but your loving presence, your unconditional love, your vows of commitment to one another. So I still greet you then, Merry Christmas, because Christmas season is ending this Sunday. It's still the Christmas season, and I also greet you Happy New Year, for indeed this is a new beginning for you, Migoy and Francis. Listening to the gospel story, the message could be summed up into one word, and that word is love. And we know that this word is abused, the most abused word, because it has different levels of interpretation, or sadly, it is being corrupted by worldly and secular philosophies or principles. But the gospel is very clear. The love that is being commanded to us is not simple eros, as we borrow the Greek word, no, eros, which means erotic or sexual love. It's not merely philia, no, that is another Greek word pertaining to friendship love, love between friends. It's not spigia, that is a love between families, but it is agape. And what is agape? God's love. That's why Jesus said, "Love each other as I love you." So the model, the standard, is not simply the way human beings love each other, because oftentimes, no, that will be corrupted with selfishness, with interior motives, or hidden agenda. So our model to follow and to imitate is the way God loves each one of us. And for me to elaborate what that agape means, let's use the acronym of the word love, so that you will not forget, and that will be your standard of love to each other as husband and wife. So let's begin with the first letter, L. It stands for listening to each other. Listening. And we know that the first expression of love is listening. That's a basic gesture of love. Kaya nga ang isang relasyon ay umuusbong at lumalago kasi naramdaman nung bawat isa na sila ay pinakikinggan, sila ay inuunawa. So the way to the heart is the ears. That's why when you also put together your ears, it formed the shape of the heart. So in your married life, dialogue, communication, empathy, they are very important. You have to make each other feel that you are listened to, that the opinion of each one is valued and considered, that like the Lord, there is always a room for dialogue. Like precisely this Christmas, God became one like us so that God and man can dialogue in the person of Jesus. That is the mystery of incarnation, and that is also the basic foundation of love. The second letter, O, overlook offenses. I am not saying you will be blind to the mistake of the other, or you will not mind the offense of the other, but that phrase pertains to one important value for this married life to work and succeed. And what is that? Forgiveness. Overlook offenses. One author said that the measure of a successful marriage is not about the absence of conflict, but the presence of forgiveness. No? Okay lang mag-away kayo, kasi normal kayong mga tao. At may pakialam kayo sa bawat isa. May malasakit kayo sa bawat isa. Kaya nagkakaroon ng conflict, kaya nagkakaroon ng misunderstanding, because you are two unique individuals trying to be one. But remember, though you may have misunderstandings and conflicts later on, always choose to forgive. They say that love always begins with an emotion. Kaya nga siguro kayo nagka-inlovean, no? Kasi kinilig kayo sa bawat isa. May nakita kayong maganda sa bawat isa. It begins with emotion, with attraction. But let me remind you, Migoy and Frances, love is sustained and should end with a decision. Nagsisimula sa emosyon, pero pananatilihin, patatagalin, pagtitibayin, at sana matapos sa isang desisyon na mahalin pa rin ang bawat isa. Kahit may katupakan, may kapraningan, may kamalian, may kasalanan, may kahinaan, you will overlook these offenses and choose to forgive, choose to still love in spite of. And then of course, the next letter V, that stands for value each other. Pahalagahan nyo ang bawat isa. You know, that's the problem with married couple. As time passes by, they tend to neglect each other, saying, I'm already secured. Pinakasalan na niya ako. So, hindi na ako mag-e-effort. Hindi ko na ipapakitang mahalaga siya. Alam niya na yun. But remember, relationship should be protected, should be cared for, should really be a priority all throughout your life. Because this is a commitment that you do not only today, but for the rest of your life. Kaya lahat ng effort ng pagpapahalaga naroroon pa rin. And one concrete manifestation of valuing each other is still maintaining that respect and courtesy to one another. Kaya nga si Pope Francis, hindi lang niya sinabing say sorry, but also say please or may I. Because the problem with married couples, dahil kasal na sila, pag-aari ko na siya. Kung anong gusto ko, pwede kong gawin. Remember, the consent that you give in marriage is every day. It's a day-to-day living. So you have to seek every day the consent of each other. Hindi pwedeng dahil kasal na tayo, pwede mong ipilit kung ano yung gusto mong mangyari. No, you should always maintain respect and courtesy. You should seek permission. You should make each other feel valued and important. And then last word is letter E. It stands for express your love. And when we say expression of love, of course, they say love is not a noun but a verb. It should be manifested in doings. Yes, words will be needed. You have to say, I love you. You have to say, thank you. You have to say, you are handsome. You are beautiful. No? You have to give words of affirmation. Kailangan yun, no? Kailangan ng words of affirmation. But more than that, may you have service to each other. May you still give gifts to each other, render surprises to each other. May you express your love through hugs and kisses. And now that you are married, no, through your sexual act as a sacred union made by God, that is an expression of your love. And of course, do not forget to, one expression of your love is praying together. Praying together. Kaya nga salamat Migoy tsaka Frances kasi nagpakasal kayo sa simbahan. Ang dami kasi ngayon mag-asawa hindi nagpapakasal sa simbahan. And I am always proud of people like you who come to church, no, to receive the sacrament of matrimony. Why? Because it is an indicator that you are serious in your relationship. Kasi diba sabi nga nila, pag nagkasal sa simbahan, seryosohan na to. No, kasi walang annulment. At talagang handa mong ipagkadala, kalandakan sa lahat na mahal nyo ang bawat isa. No, kaya Migoy and Frances, salamat. No, because you are beginning your relationship right. And you have come to the church because you know this love that you have for each other is not only a human contract, but it's a divine covenant. Magkaiba kasi yung kontrata sa tipanan. Covenant is superior than contract. And in a covenant, you recognize that your married life will work not only by your own efforts, but more importantly, but by the grace of the Lord. At yan yung hinihiling natin, na alam namin mahal nyo ang bawat isa, pero may tukso, may bagyo, may unos, may pagsubok, may problema, kaya kailangan nyong kumapit kay Lord. If He becomes the center of your life, if He becomes the model of your relationship, may forever talaga. You can celebrate your silver, your golden and even diamond anniversary. Sana nga, maabot nyo yon bilang mag-asawa. And remember the words of St. Paul, if God is with us, who can be against us? Panigan nyo lang yung Diyos, kahit anong dumating na unos, bagyo, kahit pandemya pa yan, makakayanan nyo dahil nasa panig nyo ang Panginoon. Migoy and Frances, congratulations and best wishes. And do not forget, love. Listen to each other. Overlook each other's offenses. Value each other. And express your love. Prayers promise. Amen.
May I request Migoy and Frances to please rise. Principal sponsor, please stand in your respective places to bear witness to the couple exchange of vows.
My My dear Migoy and Frances, you have come here today so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love with an eternal bond in the presence of the church. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now He enriches and strengthens you through a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual self-giving and lasting fidelity. And you, dear brothers and sisters, may I ask you to help them with your prayers that they may, with courage and confidence in God's unfailing grace and love, make the pledge of love and fidelity to one another. May I now ask you, Migoy and Frances, in the presence of the church, to answer truthfully the following questions. Frances, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love and service of your husband?
Yes, Father.
Migoy, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever in the love of service of your wife?
Yes, Father.
Are you both ready to raise as good Christians the children whom God will give you?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Migoy and Frances, since it is your wish to enter into holy matrimony, please join your right hands and express your intention before God and His church. Frances, do you take Migoy here present for your lawful husband according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to him as his wife?
Yes, I do.
Do you accept him as your lawful husband?
Yes, I do.
Migoy, do you take Frances here present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, I do.
Do you give yourself to her as her husband?
Yes, I do.
Do you accept her as your lawful wife?
Yes, I do.
In the presence of God, your families, sponsors, relatives, and friends here present, I ask you to both declare your vows of marriage to one another.
Grant us, O Lord, to be one heart and one soul from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, until death do us part.
And I, by the authority of the Church, calling on all those present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the bond of marriage which you have contracted, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we shall now bless the rings, array, and Bible. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, these rings, that Migoy and Frances, who wear them, may forever live in mutual love and unbroken loyalty through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, your servants, Migoy and Frances, with sufficiency of material possessions, which this array symbolize, so that they may use them to attain eternal life. Let this array symbolize their devotion to each other's welfare and that of their children, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bless, O Lord, your servants, Migoy and Frances, with the presence of God in their lives, symbolized by this Bible. May the Lord God be the model of their relationship and be the center of their love for each other and their future children, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Migoy and Frances, please give these rings to each other.
Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit. Migoy, wear this ring as a sign of my unconditional love and fidelity to you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
I give you, Frances, I give you this array as a pledge of my dedication to your welfare and that of our children, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
And I accept them.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us formally welcome our newly wedded couple in our midst by a warm round of applause. We now stand for the prayers of the faithful.
Please all stand.
Dearly beloved, let us now pray for the church and for our newly wedded couple, Migoy and Frances, whose marriage reflects their union with Christ. Let our response be, Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church, spread over the world, for its leaders and for the rulers of our nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For Goy and Frances, now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love reaching out to others, and a lifetime of health and happiness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For the poor and the sick, and all those in trial and affliction, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
For the married couples present here, that the Lord may stir up a renewal of their commitment to love one another, and if they have not received the sacrament of matrimony, may inspire them to acquire it soon. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, look with favor upon Migoy and Frances. Grant them to remain faithful to you and to one another. At the end of a long and well-spent life, reward them with eternal happiness together with their children and all those who love them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. May I request Migoy and Frances to please kneel for the veil and cord ceremony. May we call on the veil sponsor to please come forward and place the veil over the head of the bride and the shoulder of the groom. Followed by the cord sponsor to please come forward and place the cord over the shoulder of the couple. Candle sponsor to light the wedding candle. We'll have the presentation of the gift.
Sa'yo nang makipagkandili. pinaghihintay, kundi ang aking mapatid, na ang loob mo siyang sinusundan.
Please don't stand.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offerings made on the occasion of the sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Please all stand. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Migoy and Frances, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through Him, and with Him, and in Him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Let us pray to the Lord for Migoy and Frances, who come to the altar as they begin their married life. They may also be bound together by love for one another. Holy Father, who formed man in your own image, male and female, you created them so that as husband and wife, united in body and heart, they might fulfill their calling in the world. O God, who to reveal the great design you form in your love, willed that the love of spouses for each other should foreshadow the covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacramental sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with His church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your hand over this couple, Migoy and Frances, we pray, and pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, as they enter upon this sacramental union, they may share with one another the gifts of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds, the home that they are forming, and prepare their children to become members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown with your blessings your daughter Frances, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adorn it with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, to your son, Migoy, that he may be a worthy, good, and faithful husband and a provident father. Grant, Almighty, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in your great banquet in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We offer to each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you all.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
My dear friends, behold Jesus, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My dear friends, the body of Christ.
Amen. For those who receive the Holy Communion, you may form a single line at the middle of the aisle. Please observe social distancing.
Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, give me strength. Heal me, Jesus. Hide me in thy wounds, that I may never leave thy side. From all the evil that surrounds me, defend me. And when the call of death arrives, bid me come to thee, that I may praise thee with thy saints.
Request the cord sponsor to please come forward to remove the cord. Followed by the veil sponsor to please come forward to remove the veil.
And when the call of death arrives, bid me come to thee. Forever.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union, and replenish with the one bread and the one chalice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Migoy and Frances, now that you have received the holy sacrament of matrimony, I admonish you to remain faithful to one another. Frances, love your husband, be a good housewife, persevere in love, in faith, and holiness. Migoy, love your wife as Christ loves his church, and live with her in the holy fear of the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, the all-powerful Father, grant you His joy and bless you and your children.
Amen.
May the only begotten Son of God stand by you with compassion in good times and in bad.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God pour forth His love into your hearts.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
May I now formally present to you Mr. and Mrs. Patajo. Let us give them a big round of applause. Migoy, you may now kiss your wife.
Celebrate the wonders of your name. For the word that you speak is a song of forgiveness and the song of gentle mercy and of peace. Let us wake in the morning and be filled with your love and sing songs of praise all our days. For your love is as high as the heavens above us, and your faithfulness as certain as the dawn. I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. I will celebrate the wonder of your name. A song of forgiveness and a song of gentle mercy and of peace. Yes, I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Yes, I will sing forever of your love,
couple's portrait.
What's within there's one more gift I ask of you, Lord, it would be peace here on earth, as gentle as your children's laughter all around and all around.
Please come forward, siblings of the bride. Please stand by, all the relatives of the bride from the father and mother side. Once again, please come forward, all the relatives of the bride from the father and mother side.
In Him alone is our strength. In Him alone are we justified. In Him alone are we saved.
Stand by, both parents of the couple. Can
the world ever satisfy the emptiness in our hearts?
Parents of the bride, please stay. Parents of the groom, please come forward.
In Him alone is our hope. In Him alone is our strength. Justified in Him alone are we saved. When
parents of the group
see running in search of how lonely day, let His love fill the hunger in your soul. With joy.
Thank you. Please stay, parents of the groom.
Yearn to know in Him alone is our home.
Please stand by, siblings of the groom.
In Him alone is our strength. In Him alone are we justified.
Once again, please come forward, siblings of the groom. Please stand by, all the relatives of the groom from the father and mother side. Please come forward, all the relatives of the groom from the father and mother's side. please stay, Ninong at Nina. Standby, secondary sponsors, Candle Veil Chord. Please stay, best man and maid of honor. Thank you, best man, maid of honor. Please stay. Please stand by, all the betters. Please come forward, ring better, Bible better, and coin better. Thank you. May I request all the guests to proceed at the center aisle for the showering of petals. Once again, may I request all the guests to proceed at the center aisle for the showering of petals. Once again, may I request all the guests to proceed at the center aisle for the showering of petals.